नमस्कार, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल। वेलकम टू माय चैनल कंटिन्यूअस लर्निंग। वी आर बैक अगेन विद अनदर वीडियो। इफ यू फाइंड द कंटेंट मीनिंगफुल, डू लाइक द वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल। फील फ्री टू शेयर द वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी फर्दर टाइम, लेट अस बिगिन। Continuing with our journey on understanding more about lean tools, we have already discussed about Kaizen, Pokayoke, PDCA, 5S and 7 waste in my earlier videos. The link to these videos would be mentioned in the description section below, from where you can check out to understand in case you missed out. Today, in this video, we are going to discuss about another very important tool of lean, that is JIDOKA. JIDOKA is also known as Autonomation, Intelligent Automation, Automation with a Human Touch, and Automation with Human Intelligence. So stay tuned to the end of the video to understand this concept in detail. Let us have a quick look at the Toyota Production System. JIDOKA is one of the two pillars of the Toyota Production System along with Just-in-Time. It is considered a very important key element in successful lean manufacturing implementation. It is often one of the forgotten pillars of Toyota Production System and lean manufacturing. Yet, it is one of the most important principles of lean that can help you achieve true excellence. JIDOKA is all about quality at source, or built-in quality. No company can survive without excellent quality of product and service, and JIDOKA is the route through which this is achieved. Let us understand the history of JIDOKA. JIDOKA was first used in 1896 by the Japanese inventor Sakiji Toyoda, who later became the creator of Toyota Motor Company. It was in the form of a simple device that could stop the shuttle of an automatic loom if the thread broke. The mechanism was able to detect if the thread is broken and therefore immediately shut down the machine and signal there is a problem to avoid producing defects. Afterward, the operator operating the loom had to fix the problem and reduce the production process. This was a revolutionary innovation because it allowed one operator to run more than one machine at a time and increased production capacity significantly. Due to its usefulness, a UK company bought the patent and practically provided the funding for Toyota's creation. Let us discuss more about JIDOKA. So JIDOKA allows the operation to have a built-in quality at each step of a process, so the operator does not have to watch the machine or operation. So if we have to understand the focus of JIDOKA, so JIDOKA basically focuses on three things. One, don't accept the mistakes or defects. Two, don't make the defect. Three, don't pass on the defects. So these are the basic focus areas of JIDOKA. Let us have a detailed view of JIDOKA. So it basically, as discussed, provides machine and operators the ability to detect when an abnormal condition has occurred and immediately stops work when the problem first occurs. This enables operations to build in quality at each process by eliminating root cause of defects. And then it also helps us increase work efficiency by separating workers and machines, which further eliminates the need for operations to continuously watch machines, as now they can handle several machines at once. So JIDOKA basically works on four principles, which are: number one, separates man's work from machine's work, which means man's work and machine's work are separated for better efficiency. Second, it stops the line and helps in fixing the problem, which means stop and notify for an abnormality and never let a defect pass into the next station. Third, it helps building in quality at each process. How? By attaching waste at the source and develop a mindset of doing it right the first time. And the fourth principle is prevention, that is prevention focus, analyzing the root causes, implementing countermeasures and further improving continuously. Now let us discuss the concept of JIDOKA, that how it basically works. So first, what happens? A machine detects a problem and communicates it. Why does this happen? Because a situation deviates from a normal workflow. So then the line is stopped. So once the line is stopped, the manager or the supervisor removes the causes of the defect by root cause analysis, fixes it. And once this is done, the improvement is incorporated into the standard workflow, and this becomes a continuous cycle. So now we built in quality into the process, so the goods can be produced first time right all the time. Now, since we know the basic concept of Jidoka, let us have a quick look at the tools which are used to implement Jidoka. So there are basically four kinds of tools: AndOn, AndOn Cord, Fixed Position Stop, and Pokayoke. Now let us discuss about each of the tools in detail. So the first tool is AndOn. So AndOn is a Japanese word for paper lantern. It refers to visual display that shows status information. It is often combined with audible systems such as alarm. So AndOns are basically erected to signal when line is stopped for defects or difficulties on the line, and it is also a signal for replenishment of parts. The second tool is AndOn Card. As seen in the picture, it basically is a mechanism, usually a rope, that a worker may pull to signal the need of assistance or a need for assistance, and will further stop the line if the problem is not solved under a fixed tag time. So the next and a very interesting tool of Jidoka is Fixed Position Stop. So if you can see the diagram or the picture on the right side, so it basically is a position on the assembly line where a zone process is to be completed. It is this position that the lines will stop if the abnormality is not corrected on the time at the end of tag time. So if at the end of the cycle, the abnormality is not fixed at defined timelines, the line will stop. The fourth tool of Jidoka is Pokayoke. I have already made a detailed video on this subject. You can check out in the description section. To just summarize it, it basically is a Japanese term meaning mistake proofing. It refers to low cost devices or innovations that makes it impossible to make mistakes. It helps people to make things right the first time. And its goal is to ensure zero defects. So we now know the objective of Jidoka. We now know the concept of Jidoka. We now know the tool of Jidoka. Now let us understand the steps of Jidoka. So Jidoka basically is a quality control process that applies the following four principles or steps. Number one, detect the abnormality. Number two, stop the line. Number three, fix or correct the immediate condition. And number four, investigate the root cause and install a countermeasure. So these are four basic steps which are used to implement Jidoka. Let us understand this in pictorial form. So whenever there is a defect identified by the machine, you know, we stop the line, we review, we change the process by stopping the line, analyzing the root cause and fixing it, and then we further proceed. So this is basically a flow in which the Jidoka is implemented. Now we know the concept, we know the tool, and we know the process. Now we should understand when to stop the line for Jidoka. So the first situation is quality issue, probably one of the main reasons to stop a process if there are quality problems. A couple of things can happen if you pass quality issues down the value stream. The defective part continues to be processed and value is added to a defective product that may have to be thrown out. So if you build a complete engine where the cylinder is misaligned, you throw out the complete engine, not only the engine block. Second, even if the product can be salvaged, the more work has to be done after the defect, the more effort it will take to fix the issue. Third, the delay between the cause of the problem and detection of the issue may lead to many more defective problems because the problem is not identified early on. If your machine tool is misaligned, all parts produced since then or since the first defect will have more defect. Second case is process issues. There may also be issues with the process that may not lead to quality problems, or at least not immediately. In this case, the process should be stopped too. For example, if the machine is overheating, it should be stopped and investigated. Even if the quality of the part is still good, an overheating machine may eventually lead to defective parts or to a machine breakdown. The third case is material supply issue. So another common example for a process to stop even when there is no impact on quality is to fill up the material supply for a process or set up a new part. This can also be seen as quality, as the process is not working normally but rather being prepared. And of course, you need to stop the process for a setup. You have to stop it. Now let us have a quick look on the evolution towards judoka. So earlier we used to have machines with manual feed and operator had to watch the machine cycle manually. Then we improved it. We had an automated, an automatic feed system, but the operator still had to monitor it. But since judoka evolved over time and the processes improved, now this is a proper process with judoka implemented, that we have an automatic feed and an end-on light and an automatic ejection. So this is a self-monitoring machine. Now the operator's work and machine's works are separated. Now one operator can focus on more machines and the efficiency hence improves. So this is one of the reasons why judoka is very, very advantageous. To summarize things, let us quickly look on to the benefits of judoka. The first benefit is it helps us detect a problem earlier. The second is it avoids spread of bad practices. The third is a level of human intelligence is transferred into automated machinery. The fourth is that no defective products are produced. And the fifth one is tremendous improvement is observed in terms of productivity. The efficiencies improve drastically. So friends, this is it for today's video. Thank you for watching. I believe the concept of judoka would be clear to all of you by now, that why do we need it, what are the advantages, how should we do it, when to do it, and where to do it. So if you find the content meaningful, please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Do not forget to hit the bell icon to stay tuned to the latest updates. Feel free to share the video with your friends. You can also follow us on Instagram and Facebook. We will be back again with another video. Till then, bye-bye.